my name is John Ellingson, and welcome to How Do You Do? Welcome to the Puppet Shop. Today, we are making a very talkative puppet made from an old paintbrush. And it's going to look something like this. How you doing, Mr. Paintbrush?
I'm doing great.
Is it fun being a paintbrush?
Yes, I love painting.
This is what we're going to make today. I can't wait to show you how to make your very own at home. Here we go. Let's make one. Yay! So, to make this puppet, you're going to need a few things that I'm pretty sure you might have in your house. First of all, you might be looking for some paintbrushes. I paint a lot, so I have some old paintbrushes. I have a brand new one here that I could use. So, brand new, never been painted with. You could probably get one of these. If you only have a small paintbrush, I think that might work too. But we're going to look in your house, look for a paintbrush. The bigger it is, probably the easier it is. But I bet you find a paintbrush in your house that will work. So once you find a paintbrush, pick the brush that you want to use. I'm going to pick this one to use. So I'm going to put these other brushes over there. Then what we're going to need is, this is the kind of the specialty item to make our puppet. These are hair ties. These are little cloth hair ties. And this is what we're going to use to become the mouth. These are sold at every grocery store, and I bet if there are several children in your house, or even your mom might have one of these, they're like a miniature scrunchie. I have them in bunches of color. One of those will be needed. Then you're going to need some string. This is one of my favorite strings to work with. This is like a wax cord string. I use it for marionette puppets. Really any string will do. The less big, the better, the less thick, because we don't want to be able to see the string that much. So I bet a thick sewing string would work. You could use a shoelace. That's a bit of a thicker string, but try to find the smallest string. Fishing line could work, but some type of thin string that is in your house. You will need a pair of scissors. You will need, of course, what do I love to use on puppets? Ping pong balls. These are my new ping pong balls that I just saw at the store. I'm always looking for these. This is called miniature beer pong. But look at these tiny, itty bitty little eyeballs. They're so great. It's a ping pong ball that is extra tiny. I love that. So I'll pick my, I'll pick the ping pong balls that I think will best be the right size. You can use a lot of other things for eyes. Ping pong balls are my favorite. We've talked about using spoons or pom-poms or even paper cut out in a circle. But for my puppet today, I'm gonna use a ping pong ball because that's what I have. We're also going to need some type of ring. These are for keys, to put your keys on, a key ring. You might have an old key ring that maybe your parents could take off a set of keys. But this is what we're gonna use for our mechanism, or mech, our mechanical device that allows the puppet to talk. And so this is the string will go from our mouth all the way down to that ring, and that is what allows us to make the puppet talk. Hello. Hello. And then of course, if you're using ping pong balls, you're gonna need pupils, which I like to use my door skids. I collect all sorts of round black stickers for the pupils. And the last thing we will need is our hot glue gun, which I'm going to plug in now. Be careful, it gets hot. You'll probably want an adult. So this is what you will need to make your brush come to life. So now that you've got your supplies, let's make our paintbrush puppet. So pick your weapon. I'm gonna use this old brush. It's been painted with, and I think this will turn into a great little puppet. So first thing you're gonna do is, depending on how many hair ties you may have in your house, I wanna pick the color that you want. Usually something that'll stand out or pop against whatever paintbrush. Kind of like that pink one. I'm gonna pick that one. And then we're gonna pick our eyes for our paintbrush. These are my jumbo ping pong balls. These are super, super big. I love these. I order these online. Wow, that would be gigantic eyes. I feel like that would be very funny, but I think that might be too big for this puppet. These are my tiny, tiny ping pong balls. That looks like a very symmetrical face. So I think I want the eyes just slightly oversized, but not as oversized as the jumbo. So I'm gonna go with the traditional size. Yeah, I think that looks quite fun. So I'm gonna use this mouth, these ping pong balls. First thing we're gonna do is attach these items to our paintbrush, and then we'll work on making our mechanism, our mouth, start working. So let's check our hot glue gun and see if it is warmed up enough. Ooh, hot, warm. Hot glue gun test. Oop, yep, ready to go. I'm gonna put my mouth on first, because I think the mouth can't be on the bristles, and if it goes too low, it will be too far away from the eyes, but I think I'd rather put this on first and then put the eyes where it matches best with the mouth. So what we're gonna try to do is put some hot glue along what will be the top of the mouth, and then when we're gonna tie a string to the bottom lip, it'll look closed when nothing is happening, and then when we pull on the string, the mouth will open. So we're gonna try to make this circle, this tie that's in the shape of an O, into the shape of a closed mouth, or like a rectangle. And then when we pull, it will open. Best way I've thought to do this is decide where you want it to go, and we're gonna put our glue on the brush and put our tie onto the glue. I found it a lot harder to get your glue on here and put it on there. My fingers got ouched a bunch more. They make these thicker. This was the only size I had in my puppet shop, so this is the smallest. Whoop, there it goes, flew away. Ah, magic. This is the smallest size I've ever seen. If they were a little thicker, I think I wouldn't be as scared to get glue on my fingers. So this is a good time to have an adult help you. And I keep saying have the adult help with the hot glue gun. I'm sorry, adults, if you're getting a lot of burnt fingers from How Do You Do, but you know, practice makes perfect. So I'm gonna put a little bead, a line of hot glue. And I'm gonna let the hot glue just sit for a moment. It's at its most lava hot when you first put it down. So I don't want it to get too cool because then it won't stick, but I'm just gonna give it a minute to not be so razor hot. And I wanna be very careful not to get this on the bottom lip. So I'm gonna put it into the glue. And for this one, because this is elastic, if I let it go too soon, it'll actually pull away from the glue. So I'm gonna hold it here for a bit until I think it's at least almost dry before I let go. Otherwise it's not gonna keep that long shape. It's gonna let itself kind of turn back into the O shape. So now we wait for a minute. We've got it started, so I put in about an inch worth based on the hair tie I'm using. Now I'm gonna do a little bit further. I want it to stretch out so it's that long shape. So I'm gonna do one side at a time, which will be easier on my fingers. So I'm gonna put a little bit more glue on this side. I'm gonna give it just that few seconds to kind of cool down a little bit. And then I'm gonna stretch this into it. See if that's holding good. Do the same thing to the other side. Second. And then we'll kind of roll that into that side, hold it down, and then I think we have our mouth in its closed position, its long shape. And I'm going to pick off any little scragglers of hot glue. When you have a big hot glue project, when I'm working on a full puppet, maybe gluing all sorts of things on, if you take a blow dryer and heat up, all those little wispies of hot glue will go away. Pro tip. So now that we have our mouth on, it's ready to be pulled to open, which would be kind of exciting, but I'm gonna let that glue really be secure. So I'm gonna leave that be, but now I'm ready. Now that the lips are on, we can decide where our eyes go. So I could go way up here. This is all what you think the character looks the best. It could go, I think if it's too close, it's gonna get in the way. So I think for mine, I'm gonna put them just right above the bristles. I think that will look nice. I kinda like it going up there though. Let's go a little higher for this one. See if I can get this to glue into the bristles. So I'm gonna do one eyeball at a time. There's that one. I'm gonna kind of do both before it fully dries, because then I can slightly move them about if I don't think they're quite right. Kind of like that. Though I just put it on, so I probably shouldn't hold it up yet. Kind of pushing it into those bristles. Gonna hold those down for a minute. Oh, I like that. That kind of made the hair go a little more funky. So now if you look at that, I've got my closed mouth and my eyes on my paintbrush puppet. What's great about this is because it's a paintbrush, you already have a little handle. And he doesn't have his pupils yet, but he's a very easy puppet to look down.
up. Talk to the that way. Talk to the that way. He can get close. He can get far. Just by moving your arm and holding onto this brush, he already has a lot of expression. And now, we're ready to make him talk. So I'm gonna take a bit of string. This is a black nylon wax string. I'm gonna take a bit more than I need. And the first thing I'm gonna do is tie this to the bottom lip. And I want it in close as I can get to the center of the bottom lip, in the middle of it. I'm gonna pull that pretty tight. And I want my knot to be facing down. So it'll be facing the ring, which is what I pull on. So, facing down. And I'm gonna do a few knots. I like to put a little glue on my knots just to make sure, especially with puppets, that they don't come undone. I find puppets, when they do come undone, it's usually during the show when people are watching. Before I glue it though, or get rid of this tail, which I don't want, I'm gonna put the ring on it and make sure it works, and then I'll secure it all down. So now that we've tied string onto our bottom lip, when you pull on this cord, hello, it talks. It talks, I can talk, I'm a real talking brush. You're gonna use the bottom of the brush to hold on to. I like that this, if it goes too long, it's harder to pull, but if you go too far up, your hand will be in the shot, or you'll see the hand more. Wherever I hold onto the brush, I want the ring to go just a little bit below my hands. I find that way my talking hand will not be in the way of the hand I'm using to operate the brush. So that to me looks like, mine is roughly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, about a foot, about 11 to 12 inches. So, let me get rid of a little bit of this extra, which I don't need. I'm going to tie my string at that point, about 11 to 12 inches down. That's how it measures from my brush and where my hand is. Depends on which brush or object you chose to put eyes and a mouth on. So I'm gonna tie a few knots here, and just like the knot on the lip, as you can see, it's already come undone a little bit. I'm gonna make sure that works, and if it does work well, I will hot glue the knots and get rid of the extra string. Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba. Excellent. All right, a little bit of glue on this knot. Be very careful of your fingers. I can never say it enough, good trick, if you ever get hot glue on your fingers, just rub them together as quickly as you can, as fast as you can. That'll make the pain go away. Have that one go back just a little bit. Again, I want as little stuff around the lip, because the more stuff that's up and around it, the more you'll notice it. But a little bit of knot security there is good. So we'll let that dry. As that's drying, I'm gonna clean up a little bit, and then we'll put our pupils on. Okay, I think that's dry enough. So I'm gonna get rid of my extra string, the tails, because they would get in my way. Oops. All right, so now we have our puppet talking, and he needs to be able to see a little bit better with his pupils. So today I'm gonna use, I talk about slip pads for the bottom of chairs. These look exactly like them, but these are ones I order online. They're basically the same thing. I just have a little bit more variety in size. And my pupil trick, again, is to take a straight pin for sewing. And I'm gonna go for the, this is my typical size that I like to do, about half an inch. And I use these. The first one is always easy. I find it harder to get the second pupil to be symmetrical in the exact same place on the other side. I find it easy to get that one, but my fingers, and maybe you have smaller hands than I do, so it won't be as hard. For me, I find great difficulty in putting that other pupil in a mirrored position. So I use this so I can kind of see, is that where I want it? And then I can make sure I like it. Let's take a look at that. Ooh, I do, I think I do like that. I think I do. Do you? Ooh, hello. Hello. We did it! This is a pretty easy puppet to make. All you need is a hair tie and some eyes, and then you have a talking paintbrush puppet. There you go. So I hope you have some ping pong balls or some white paper you could cut in circles, a marker for pupils or some chair slides, an old paintbrush, a ring, some string, and a tiny little scrunchie. And then you can make your puppet talk. That's so great. I think I might make a few more. Enjoyed our puppet making today, and I hope you make your very own paintbrush puppet. They're really good at singing songs, I think. Thanks so much for joining on How Do You Do? I go live on Tuesdays at 1 o'clock, so if you want to come with some questions or tell me about the puppet that you made this week, and check in for more videos coming out every week. Thanks, everybody. Enjoy your puppet making time. See you next time. I should go paint something.